I'm just going to reflect upon one of the first comments that Dr. Thangam made, which is about the nuclear family and the disintegration of values, especially the Indian values. You know, the surprising fact that we look at almost all over the world is that the world is looking upon us to teach them what we call as value-based education. And on the other side, we find that India is busy trying to ape I don't know which part of the world, which doesn't seem to exist. It's somewhere in the fantasy worlds that we seem to have created in these OTT platforms. And we are busy not wanting to adopt any of the values, like ma'am rightly said, whether it is the Chanda Mamas or the Parody Tales or the Panchatantras, we seem to have it all in our hands. It's basically like, you know, ghar ki murgi dal barabar. You have all the right ingredients with you, but somehow when it comes to life skills, A, we refuse to learn from the wisdom that is packaged and given to us by our lovely parents at home, because somehow the other parents don't know it. I mean, I know better because I am exposed to the rest of the world. And partly it also comes from the fact that, okay, maybe parents are not so pushy about the fact that they actually want us to do well in life, and the packaging that goes around in this kind of wisdom that is bottled and handed over to us at that early an age somehow doesn't seem to have made the right impact. For those children who have actually adopted it, or those cultural homes where they believe that yes, they need to actually have accepted it, you can see the kind of quality of children that they come out of. And where children have not been, or if I may use the term, have been orphaned with, you know, these value-based education system, you can see the kind of children who are coming out. So in this background, I mean, I must thank Thangam ma'am to have brought out this point so very relevant today. Because here we are talking about the relevance of life skills or the relevance of social competencies in a digital world. Look at it this way. Less than a year and a half back, we've been suddenly forced indoors. And before any one of us could have even been prepared for what we were walking into, we suddenly realize that now we have no escape from the four walls of our house. You need to be at home and you need to be able to start surviving as you used to do before. Just the rules of the game has changed. Now, I don't think any one of us can even claim to be remotely prepared for this. Not even us, Jio, the company that we believe that actually helped us in a big way in terms of managing this digital bridge that was required during this period of time. But yet, I will go on in terms of saying that, okay, what do we do? I mean, look at it this way. Last year, when we used to hire people in our company, we have a simple formula which I'm sure all of us have been there. In fact, even Sheshasai sir would agree with this, because they would normally in every company they teach you in this HR world is that they say, okay, you shortlist for knowledge, you hire for attitude, train for skills. This is a normal benchmark that is used by everybody, a basic guideline that is taught in any HR school. And what do we have? We have the competency benchmark, which is competency nothing but knowledge, attitude and skills. In fact, I think in one of the Q&As that is there out here, one of your students have already asked this question, what is the relevance of life skills? Why do I need to learn life skills? But is it not enough if I just pick up all the knowledge and all the skills? Is it not enough? Do I also need to learn life skills? So somewhere along the line, maybe the word life skill is what possibly did not click in their head. When we are actually referring to is the attitude. And obviously, I mean, let's say for example, but let's talk about competence in this digital world. What do we have? When you come to knowledge, I think Dr. Bakshi also brought about this fact, where he said that, okay, today where knowledge is available on a tap, if you want any kind of knowledge, it's available on a screen. You just tap it and you have it all with you. Dr. Google seems to have provided every single answer for you. Whether it is in terms of if you don't have that, then possibly your social media friends and family will possibly be able to provide it to you. When it comes to digital skills, today people are actually looking for wanting to learn AR, VR, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and all these fancy jargon that people are throwing at each other. But what has happened is, what happens to your natural skills? The basic foundations that you are supposed to have picked up at the early stage, on top of which any of these elements were supposed to come in based on your natural interest is where you could. Not everybody needs to be an AI engineer, but you need to know how to apply this in your day-to-day life. Tomorrow we are talking about moving on from 4G to 5G technology. The day is going to be not too far when your mobile phone is going to talk to your microwave in your house, or when your car keys are actually going to start talking to the air conditioner in your house. That day is not too far away. And for that aspect, you at least need to know how to control that environment rather than becoming a slave of these instruments in your hand. As it is today, you see, most people would almost have a heart attack if they lose their mobile. Isn't it? People are willing to actually ensure that they are even their best friends, forget their best friend, even their spouses should not know the password of their mobile devices. God alone knows what secrets are there. But anyway, we'll not go there. But we are talking about this kind of a world that we walked into. And there, when we are talking about digital attitude, we are talking about basic things. I mean, we had, I think Dr. Murli mentioned about, you know, the issues about how people are so stressed in the digital world. The aspects of suicide. Yeah, sure enough, people do not even want to talk to each other. You put four teenagers in a room, take away their mobile phones, they don't know what to do with each other. I haven't had that experience when I was growing up. Okay, I may be all of 50 plus, doesn't matter. I do not think that we ever waited for an opportunity. I would jump over our fence and go away to neighbor's house and possibly eat or drink or do whatever I have to. I don't think I worried anything about it. I would play till I was almost ready to go to sleep. We would possibly climb every tree. I had a function in my house the other day when my daughter was getting married, and there was a, what you call as your Sumangali Pratna happening in the house. And we had a child who came to our house. This child has obviously been so cocooned in the household environment. She came home and she was playing with the rest of the children in the open garden that we have. Suddenly she came crying into the house. I mean, this is the corona period, obviously. So we thought, okay, something happened, and she was holding up her hands and she was crying for her mommy, mommy, mommy. And we thought, okay, what happened now? What the heck is going on? And we kind of all stopped and we asked her, okay, just tell us what happened. She said, mommy, I touched a tree. I need to wash my hands. I almost slapped the kid. She is almost 8 years of age and she doesn't even know what she's missing out on life. I mean, we are a kind of generation who would possibly go and steal fruits from the neighbor's tree, eat it off the tree. And we are pretty healthy guys out here. I mean, the younger generation today possibly is missing out on a whole lot of stuff. They do not even know how to smell the flowers on this tree. Where have we failed as a generation? I do not know. But then in the process of chasing digital, have we forgotten life? I am not too sure. The other day, a company came to us and said that, okay, sir, we have created a company called a Labster. I'm sure Dr. Thangam would be very interested in this, because this company, Labster, allows you to conduct all science experiments that we would do. We would be enjoying breaking test tubes, getting beaten up by the lab assistant for actually making all these kind of silly experiments and burning our fingers and all these things we learned. That is why it was called a lab. And here is this guy, the company based out of Stockholm, which is actually helping you to do the entire thing digitally. Which means what? You just wear some digital devices and you actually do all the experiment. As I talk to you right now, I can smell sulfur in my nose. Imagine children not even getting to know what this is all about. That's the world we're walking away with. Because when we are talking about new world innovations, we're talking about study and work from home. Look at this. In fact, the other day there was a WhatsApp joke that told us that, okay, what would you do with a child who's actually come to you for an interview and he said that he's actually a student who passed out of 12th in the year of 2021? I would say, stay home, stay safe. Why would I bring that kid into my school or in my college or in my company? Imagine the fate of those children. I mean, it is not their fault at all. But neither has been anybody in our society able to do anything about being able to help them out in this situation. We have not done anything to do that extra mile to get them to end. Anyway, none of us are responsible, because everybody was getting incremental 1 month, 2 month extra dose. Okay, more postponed, finally the entire year went up. And now we understand very, and I don't know, from Ministry of Education, the notice says that the next academic year is going to be completely study from home. And they're all busy preparing themselves by distributing tablets and laptops and God knows what, just so that children can be at home. Doling out these devices, I'm not too sure whether those are the kind of solutions to what we are working with. Your usage of platforms, for example, if you look at it, I mean, children are so self-centric. I think we also heard the word selfish being used when we were referring to our kind of audience. This selfish attitude is also coming because obviously most of the children are so happy playing around with your Instagrams, where they live in a make-believe world. The same curd rice that you possibly must be having out there every other day suddenly gets dressed up, made into a photograph as though some chef from a five-star hotel has delivered it to you, and then you are happy to have it. But if the same thing was delivered with lot more love and stories and values given to you by your grandmother, which I think even I cherish to this day, I do not know whether this generation understands the value of it. We're talking about the generation of the so-called OTT platforms like your Netflixes and the Amazon Primes, or let's say even your Swiggy and your Google Pay. See, come to think of it, many of us have learned to cope up with this situation. The average household lady, forget about the average household lady, even if you took up somebody from the slums, that person selling that idli outside that slum area, he has learned how to create a QR code for himself and create a Google Pay account. Very quickly we have moved that ladder. So it's great for a country like India, because if you had conducted coaching classes for teaching you how to do digital payment system, I don't think you would have kept up with this. But India has moved on very fast. But along with this kind of freedom comes responsibility. Look at the kind of stuff that is now floating in your hands. I mean, with the touch of a finger, you could watch anything you possibly would want to. But do we know what we've handed over to our children? There is no censor. Obviously, morality is at an all-time low. We have so many situations like this, we do not know what we have walked into. We are hoping that somehow we will survive and get onto the other side very safe. I do miss the old world. I do miss my teachers. I do miss the smell and look and feel of my institutions and my labs. I do miss the social interactions that we were providing our children in various areas, including the skills. Teachers are also learning today. I don't think any teacher was prepared for the fact that she has to sit in front of a computer or a mobile and start teaching. I don't think so. And not every teacher is a very pretty lady that she's actually going to be able to hold attention just because of being able to do that. Because right now she's under so much of inspection. Parents are deciding what the teacher should be looking like, wearing, and God knows what. And not only is she teaching a class, she's having to take care of the parents, and every day seems to be a parent-teacher meeting. Attitude. We talked about it just a few minutes back. Integrity. Is this important alone? We have half of our children who just start on their Zoom classes or whatever. They switch it off and they go away and they come back towards the end of the day because the attendance is taken care of. And parents are very happy about it. Parents are saying, okay, fine, you can, as long as you're studying and getting your marks, and anyway at the end of the year there is no exam, so you'll get passed. Good, no problem, continue, keep watching the movie with us. That integrity you've started at home. And with these kind of skills, whether it is EQ, whether it is facilitation skills, your leadership skills, learning from everyone. Remember somebody talked about, I do not mind learning from a younger person than me. We talked, I think Dr. Murli mentioned that, saying that I should be, or Dr. Sheshai said that I should not be afraid of learning from anyone. Even if that person is younger than me, I should be happy to learn from them. Absolutely, I agree with you also. I mean, do you remember that famous incident in the Ravana or the Ramayana story where Ravana is dead and lying on the battlefield, and Rama sends Lakshmana over to say that, okay, go to him. He's a learned Brahmin. Go to him, he may be an Asura, but go and learn from him certain skills and come back. Lakshmana comes back disappointed, saying that Ravana is refusing to impart the wisdom to me. Rama asks him, tell me, how did you go and approach him? He said, I went and stood near his head. I anyway vanquished him. He's about to die. I almost wanted to kick him. But anyway, chalo. I asked him, okay, would you mind just telling me what you have to tell me so that, you know, my brother has asked me to come to you. Rama says, let me demonstrate it to you. he goes and stands at the feet of Ravana. He says, I know you erred, you made one mistake, doesn't matter, I had to kill you for that one silly stupid mistake that you made. But then we would like that the wisdom that you have acquired should not leave this world. Would you mind sharing that knowledge with us? And then Ravana starts sharing that entire knowledge, which Ravana takes from him and then moves away from him. It doesn't matter even if you are learning from an enemy, but if there is wisdom to be gained, we should be willing to be humble enough to be able to learn from every single source.